least two.
Yeah, at least two.
I have them.
Right. But I've been shooed away. I haven't been taken into consideration. I haven't been respected. Yes, but my questions still, these questions have not been answered.
We have met. Several times. You and I met back three or four times.
Me, three or four. I met with you once. I met with the, John once, 3 weeks ago.
You didn't meet?
I met with you a couple of.
Did you meet here with Dale and the building inspector and John?
No, we should.
No, I didn't. What meeting was that?
To let everyone know what you were gonna do.
No, as I told you last meeting, I didn't get notices.
I don't think that was a public notice. That was a notice to be.
Okay, well, how would I know if there was a meeting if I wasn't notified?
You had a meeting with the neighbors.
I did not know about that meeting.
The building, for that meeting, the building inspector posted notices on each house. There was a problem.
Was not on my house.
I didn't post the notice. I wasn't there when you got home.
I'm just letting you know for the record, I was never notified with a private meeting with Dale Passat.
I spoke with Michael Yanti a little while ago, and he will be working on the drainage plan as to what's there now.
Okay.
I asked him to, if he had any copies of notices that went out, and his answer was maybe with that new building, she fell outside that, is it 250 or 300 feet? Sure, you said you got notified.
No, I did not get notified. I believe it's 500 feet.
It's 500 feet. Yes, it is.
Notification for the site plan would have been a separate app.
Yeah.
It would have been. Yeah, a separate item, that would have been.
Oh, yeah, no, had nothing to do with that.
Who's Mike Modanti?
He's the engineer.
Which engineer?
For the applicant.
Oh, so we have an application for a permit?
For a site plan for the building that he's finishing up, yes.
Does that include the drainage and the, all the piping that's been put in?
It includes the work in the swale, going down to Halleck, the stuff, the fill in the backyards. No, it does not. That was not given a permit. It was an agreement between the neighbors to have a small area of ponding filled, which has gotten to be a lot more than that. And we've been asking them to provide a plan for what it is they actually proposed to do.
So clearly it is a violation there. Clearly. There's no permit.
Yes.
There's no plans. There's no plans. There's no permit. There's nothing.
Going forward, is there any plan to maintain these storm drains and drainage pipes and so forth? Unless they're maintained.
As the mayor just said, we're waiting to see the plan.
Unless they're maintained, the surface water is going nowhere else, and it's going to back up into garages and other parts of property now that are cut off from surface drainage.
I mean, as far as what they're gonna propose that we haven't seen yet, I have no idea what they're gonna propose to do to maintain that. The easement on the railroad bed, that there is no provision to maintain, and as part of his site plan approval, he agreed to go and clean it out, which is why it was cleaned.
What's the?
The swale along the railroad bed.
There's all new piping in there. And it was raised, there was soil brought in and raised, it was even higher than my property.
All right, if you want answers, you have to let people talk.
All right, go ahead.
He took a lot of garbage out of there, he took a lot of trees that were in there out, and you can argue, but the DPW that's picking the stuff up is here, they can tell you they're loading their trucks with this stuff. And yes, to maintain a better channel, he did agree to put in a pipe. A pipe will carry more water than an open swell. So he opted to spend more money to provide a better solution.
Who's the better solution for?
Does it benefit him? Absolutely, because he lives next to it too. But the man spent money that he didn't have to make an improvement. Benefits from it, as well as the properties on the other side, good for everybody.
No, it's not, because it's in violation, and the drainage easements are no longer working.
There was no violation of what we're talking about. The work in the swell was included as part of the site plan approval, and he has legal agreements with the owner of the property to let that work out.
So it benefited his property?
Everyone's.
Not mine, not mine, and not my neighbor on Nichols Street. Because we were cut off. The drainage easement that used to flow was completely cut off. 5 feet was added to the property, all the surrounding properties. Where's the water going to go?
Wasn't there a discussion from our room with you two? And again, I'm not familiar with your location or history of it.
I'm laying across the street, being built.
Yeah, I'm saying the history of the flooding. I think we were trying to get the timeline last time in place. But somebody said that a lot of the water is coming from Nicole Street. It's not coming from?
Yeah, a lot of it's.
Yeah. So this is a different issue then. Because her water is coming from Nicole Street, not what Dio just did.
Right. What Dio did was raise the property next door. Okay. And he's going to put in drains at the lowest part of that before her property, or maybe beyond the property, in the swale that exists, right, which would alleviate the water from coming from her neighbor's property over to her property.
But her flooding is still going to occur because it's coming from the coast. It's irrelevant for what Dio did.
From the coal street.
That's what I meant, yeah. So it's irrelevant what Dio did for her flooding.
Yeah, but he has to fix it, he's agreed to fix
that. I understand that, but she's still going to get flooding.
He's not going to fix it.
It's not Cole Street. Surface water from Nichols Street and 94 flows between the houses down to the railroad. If it's not raised up and the different swales violated. All those channels have been cut off by the extra fill he's put. And the fill now, between 107 Nichols Street and 105 105 East Main and 1 Nichols Street are cut off. So everything that flows from Nichols Street and 94 and from 107 East Main Street, sorry, is trapped in there. Now that drain will probably work as long as it's functional.
He did put catch basins in people's property.
Yeah.
Your neighbor, and I think the house next door. I don't know about further. But Claire, what if her driveway is a catch basin?
She needs that.
That he put in with drainage towards the railroad. He also did the same thing with the blue house,
the 109.
Okay. Same thing there. I don't know if he went down another house. Yeah. I don't know. So now he has all of that taken care of. He's going to do the same thing on the right side of Claire's house, putting a drain in down to the railroad. That's what he said he was going to do less than 2 weeks ago. I don't know what else we could ask him to do.
I think when you see the plans, you should take a look at where the surface water is going as well. independent of the drains.
I don't disagree with what you said. What he was originally requesting to do, which he was allowed to do by agreement with the neighbor, you had areas that every time it rained, you had a pond in the rear of those yards. You agree, disagree?
And behind Claire's house, there was a pond.
Correct.
And then when that was filled in, it started to be a pond on my yard.
And all he was originally going to do is fill in that low area.
Right, but where did the surface water go in that low area, which is now 5 feet high?
Which was part of the reason why he was cleaning up that swale, so that we could go from a higher elevation to a lower elevation and let the water run. What he has done since then, he's just done. We still haven't received the plan for it. So we haven't had anything to look at to see if what he wants to do or is doing is going to work.
Not an engineer, but common sense tells me the water will go in the lowest area.
Which is why we dug the swale to make it.
The lowest area now is my property that the water's going on.
And that's why Dio said that he drained it?
Right, but what about my driveway that is no longer there? Is that going to take care of all of that? Because before it used to drain.
That water's coming from 94 and 94 and Nicole Street. It's nothing to do with Dio.
Excuse me, it does, because you're not hearing what I said from the very beginning. If you look at the drainage easement on everyone's deeds, the water used to flow through the properties, around, and there was a drain. It would go underneath the track and then to Cornwall somewhere. It used to flow until it was tampered with. So yeah, so if he puts the drain in, where's the water going to go? It's going to only take care of that one little side of the property.
So you're saying what from Nicole and 94 used to come down your driveway?
Yes.
Go to your backyard?
Yes.
Go to the railroad bed?
Around, yes.
And then go down to your
corner? That's right. That's where the drainage is. Everyone's property.
That's what used to happen?
That's, it used to happen, yeah. When there were leaves in there, we would clean out the leaves and then the water would flow.
Oh, she's not wrong. When that house that had this well that filled it in, put a pool in.
Screwed up everything.
That's what I mean. As far as what I understand, that's where it's
that's what I understand, too. I don't know what number house that was, but it was, she was on a TV show, and so he decided to fill in the swell.
So what Dio was originally supposed to do to establish a new path to get the water into this well.
Which he has, maybe not completed yet until that other pipe has been put in.
When we get the plan, we can look at it. It's all done.
So, is that going to alleviate the water coming from the upholstery into her driveway and then leave her driveway?
Alleviating it coming in? No.
Yeah.
Where it goes from once it's on her property. Yeah, then we have the plan, we can look and make sure that it's not going to stay there, but we can't do anything about what's coming onto the property.
Years ago, there was talk that they were going to put a storm drain on it.
We did look at doing with the elevations of the water and gas mains in the road. It was a lot more than just putting in the catch basin. To get a drainage pipe across would mean getting ORM to move their gas main as well as resetting the elevation of the water main, which extends into ripping out part of Route 94 to be able to move up and down the connections out of the state highway. So it became a very substantial project trying to get drainage into that road. What the village board did several years ago asked us to look at it.
What's the timeframe on getting the information from Mr. Fassad? Because we're gonna get into winter, the ground is gonna freeze, and no work will be able to get done.
I believe he's due back in country this week. Okay, it's about 2 weeks since I spoke to him. I spoke to Mike Mugatti today, but I will get on him also to see if he could. Provide plans as soon as possible. But I guess until then, we're really still guessing what can happen. And maybe I can ask him to go further, try to put something in the driveway. I don't know. You know, he's only gonna do what he feels he needs to.
And this is okay with the village?
Is that gonna go, would you let him work on your property?
I'm asking you, this is okay with the village, what he's done?